when the Yankee boats actually came in, they came into the wrong creek. They went into Indian Creek and went all the way up there until they couldn't go any further, and then they called in the shallow boats and sent them on up and found out that they were in the, found out from people that had gotten off the boat in Dymer Creek that they were in the wrong creek. So they started back, and this time they were shelling on both sides, and that way they, and they came up that way. The main place that was shelled was the Edmonds home. It was all the way up in Indian Creek, where we think that homes were actually burned or shelled. Well, when they started shelling over on Dymer Creek, over on Indian Creek on the way out, the shells, many of them would come all the way across to Dymer Creek, where Betsy's plantation was. She said that the shell came across saying, which way, and boom, it would hit a building, and there would go this part of another part, like the steeple that was on the barn and the corn house and things like that that were shot up. And but she went down to the where the slave house was, see but Uncle Emerson, because he was stoned up deaf, and he was old. And she went in there and found him. He was sitting there enjoying everything as usual. And she tried to get him. Uncle Emerson, for God's sake, come on, she said. And she finally made him understand what was going on. And when she did, Uncle Emerson began to roll and roll right back under the bed. Then she had a whole lot more trouble getting him out. But finally she got him out, and she found out that the slaves had gone down on the Dymer shore of the farm and were hidden in a sort of a cave that they called it down there, had built a fire and were eating sweet potatoes. And finally Uncle Emerson found out what was going on. When he did, he got up and ran as hard as he could to go down there and join them. But all the time, the butter room was going on, and different places were losing their parts.